Sounds like a sick cat.
That's why, because it was piled up.
These are the voyages of Treasured Times, her continuing mission to explore the oceans of South Florida and the Caribbean, to seek out unknown islands and forgotten places, to give an unforgettable adventure to everyone who is welcomed aboard. I'm Captain Adrian Collada, and this is First Mate and Mechanic Engineer Michael Collada, and this is our little bird Squeaky. On our floating home away from home, the three of us are always looking for our next adventure. Sometimes when we least expect it, the adventure finds us instead. Welcome aboard Treasured Times. Engineer's Log, October 24th, 2020. The day started off with a trip to Home Depot. The development of Tropical Storm Zeta just south of Cuba has caused a windy mess for us in South Florida. We decided to take the opportunity to complete some of the unending tasks on Treasured Times. First on the list, the installation of new chain. We currently have 100 feet of chain that allows us to anchor at 15 to 20 feet of water. This new chain is well over 200 feet and will allow us to anchor at even greater depths. Spray paint markings on the chain will let us know how much we are paying out. I'm sure by now you may have noticed the storage container on the anchor pulpit. It is filled with 600 feet of rope, also known as anchor road, and will allow us to anchor at up to 100 feet of water. A divider will need to be built in the chain locker so we can store it there instead. That's a job for another day. As we were finishing unloading the old chain, Ronnie came over for a visit and to tell us how unusually high the tide has been over the last week. He said the wind had also been blowing at 30 miles per hour over the past couple of days. Apparently the tide and the wind had pushed our fenders onto the dock and the seawall, causing the boat to push against the pilings and eventually breaking one of them. And I quote, he said that tide was unreal.
Broke?
Yeah.
Wow. That tide must have been super high.
It was unreal.
Going in. Got to fill in that area because there's sitting water. Don't want the chain sitting in that water. There's a lot of room in here, look at that. I mean, I could fit in here. It's quite comfortable. Well, I don't think I'd want to take a nap in here or anything. Nah.
Fit in between there?
In between what and what? Oh, between the anchor and the side, yeah. Yeah, it fits. Yeah, that fits.
It's okay.
Just put one piece here, but it would need to stick out a little bit more so the chain doesn't slide in. You think so?
Now you're talking some complex shit.
Because we just need a board that goes here, here, and like along the back.
What's going on?
Well, initializing an autopilot and the pump is probably 20 years old, so.
Let's give it a whirl here.
Once we finished the chain locker base, it was on to the next project.
I can hear it.
You can see the rudder on that side.
Sounds like a sick cat.
It's right under there.
There wasn't much left to do with the autopilot since we were at the dock. So on to the next project, changing the port of call lettering to match what we registered with the Coast Guard. I was happy to have this project done. The wind did not make it easy. A couple of weeks ago, Tyler and I attempted to clean the wheels, but they were still filthy dirty and loaded with growth, causing a vibration at low speeds. It was Mike's turn this time. He spent a good 12 hours over the course of 2 days to make them shine like new again. While Mike was below the stern cleaning the props, I was on the bow power washing the layers of dirt that had been building up. Some of the paint was also not bonded well in some areas. We're gonna need some no-skid paint soon, and that is a project for another day as well.
Tighten it a little.
let it out. Let me let it out. Push. Now tighten it. I just need to go really slow, I think. It's just the chain, I think, is twisted right there. Bunched up right there. Oh, it's because the chain is piled up.
Pile of chain,
that's why. That's why, because it was piled up. It's pulling the boat over.
Never-ending boat maintenance and repairs are always on the agenda when the weather doesn't cooperate. Sometimes I find myself satellite scrolling for some possible and exciting future trips and excursions. And this one is definitely on the list. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe, and don't forget to click that notification bell. See you all next week.